We mean hello. Hi. And welcome to Working Title / Three Girls Gabbing. We're so excited here. Michelle.
Hello.
Christina.
Hey.
And me, Alex. So today on our movie / TV section, we're talking about something that we are all so excited about. We couldn't wait for it to come back. You guessed it. Girls! Oh, so.
Feelings?
What'd you guys think? Just give it to me.
All the emotions, like you wrote in the text. I'm feeling it all.
All the feels.
Literally, the feels. Yeah. So there was some heavy stuff. Well, first and foremost, before we get into the seasons, because as you guys know, it was the season, four seasons, a year in the life. So it was winter, it was spring, it was summer, and it was fall. So the final four / I know we talked about this briefly, Michelle. You thought it was three words.
Yeah, the final three words. The final four words, final three words.
Me too. Yeah. So the words were, just kidding, no spoilers here because
It was a pretty big bombshell.
It was.
Yeah.
But I get what you're saying. I feel like the important words were the last two of the four words.
Yeah.
The first two words were just pointless.
Can you believe though that Rory is pregnant? Can you believe that?
No. I didn't see it coming.
I can't, yeah. And then I was rewatching it again today and she was taking care of Paris's kids and I was like, oh my god, this is a foreshadowing.
That was great.
It's crazy. But I think it's very full circle, type moment, and it makes sense. The only thing I do have to say, so you know how Amy Sherman Palladino, these have been the final three or four words or whatever that she knew she was gonna end the series with. The only question I'll say I have is say if the series completely ended in season six.
Okay.
But when she left, or even if she was there for season seven and that's where it ended, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I would have been really upset if Rory got pregnant, right after graduating college.
You know
what I mean?
Why?
Just because I feel Rory, the whole, trajectory of her life, she's doing more. She's trying to be, the anti-her mother, you know what I mean? At least in, the things she's trying to achieve in life. So I feel like her getting pregnant almost is going to, stop the path that we hoped that she would go on. Not that she was as successful as I feel like she even thought she would be. But, I mean, she wrote, articles for the New Yorker, so that's a major accomplishment. But yeah, I would have just been a little upset if that had happened that soon. So, but other than that,
so
I loved it.
Now, who do you think the father is?
Oh my god,
the Wookiee. No, I don't think it was him.
Yeah, I feel if it was him, she would have known she was pregnant earlier because that happened in spring.
Do you think she knew she was pregnant this entire during all the seasons?
I don't think so.
No,
I mean, I personally don't think so.
I didn't get that feeling either.
Yeah. I mean,
I think only in fall she realized she was pregnant.
Exactly. And then when she's talking to Christopher at the end right before,
I didn't get that until the end, though. I thought she was doing that for her book.
Exactly. Which also, she's writing a book. Yeah. And can I just say that I personally thought that, when they started, introducing that book and things like that, when it was going to be about her life.
Jess's idea. You should write about your mother.
Exactly. Yeah. I feel like, as I was preparing for the revival, as I was preparing for the revival, seeing them and their interactions and their love, I was okay, I get it a lot more. They're kind of meant for each other.
Who? Jess?
Jess and Rory. Yeah. But anyway, so what I was gonna say was I was watch the series end, the entire thing has just been her telling the story. The entire season of Gilmore Girls and then the revival, has just been her telling her story from the book, but it didn't happen that way. So.
Yeah.
Would have been clever.
It would have been, but.
Nice job, Amy.
Right. Yeah. But so yeah, let's give it a letter grade, A through F. Start with you, Michelle.
Oh, I guess I'd have to give it either an A- or a B+. Cause I feel like some things weren't resolved. Michelle, does Michelle leave or not?
And exactly.
We sort of see Lorelai about to buy the other place where the nuns were living, but she doesn't really do that. I felt like I got closure from Emily Gilmore.
Same. Yeah. I really loved the way that her story ended.
Yeah, me too. I would give it a B+.
B+? Yeah, I think I would give it either an A- or a B+, because I really genuinely enjoyed it and loved it. And if there's no more, I think that it ended in a good enough place, very full circle, but it could totally be a whole other story.
It definitely could.
That's our review on Gilmore Girls, people. We hope you liked it. And I'm ready to talk about gossip. I don't know about you guys.
Yes, what are we talking about today?
I mean, I feel like if we're gonna talk about gossip, we gotta go with the Kardashians. There's no one else to discuss.
I know, Kourtney and Scott are back together.
Are they now?
Yep, as of 2 days ago.
Give me a little background because I don't know much about them.
So Kourtney and Scott have been together for over a decade now, really on and off. Scott has had a lot of drug problems. He went to rehab. He punched a mirror in like this alcoholic
rage. I think I saw that episode.
Remember that?
Yeah.
And so they actually have three children, Mason, Penelope, and Rain, and they have stayed like amicable throughout all of their ups and downs, but they called it quits July 2014 on Independence Day.
Oh, what a horrible Independence
Day. I know, right?
Or a great Independence Day for Kourtney. She's marking her independence.
Very true. So in the meantime, Scott went to rehab, and he's been really trying to, you know, clean up his image for Kourtney. Kourtney's been like so focused on her health and the kids. And then, they've like stayed friends, but nothing romantic. And then,
but now,
2 days ago, says they're back together.
Is that like TMZ news or like?
No.
It's like official?
It's E! News, so.
Oh, okay. So it's serious.
That's when you know.
Exactly.
That's when you know.
It's legitimate.
And so it's like wedding bells, or is it for the children, or has Scott really changed? I don't know.
I feel like Kourtney seems always so like absent and like far removed and like can't love anybody, so like does
I get that vibe too.
Yeah,
but that's why I feel like she can't date anyone else
except
like there's no way she would ever feel comfortable enough to bring another guy into her children's lives or let alone like open up to someone else.
Makes sense.
Even though Scott has all these issues and they have their backstory, I feel like it's just, you know, part of their relationship.
Maybe it's meant to be.
Soulmates.
So what do you think about that? What do you think about like drug addicts? Like if like say you're dating a guy and like you get pregnant and like then he's a drug addict and then he says he's fixed and like recovered and like he goes to rehab, like would you be comfortable going back with him?
So I don't think Scott was really a drug addict. I think he just, you know, really liked to party and recreationally abused drugs.
Yeah, no
I think
big deal.
An addict might be a different story, but for someone who just, you know, is experiencing the youthful benefits of experimentation, you know, let them be. But at some point, he is a dad and he has to set a good example for his children. And I don't know if I would let my father figure continue to abuse drugs.
Right. I mean, I don't know, like, I'm sure my dad maybe did drugs. I don't know.
Yeah.
I mean, I know my father, but, like, I don't think he, like, is a drug addict. So. Not to my knowledge. So. Pretty much it. But yeah, I think that that's great that they're back together. And what do you think about like Kanye and Kim? Because Kanye is crazy. Is he on drugs too?
I know, so.
Probably.
Honestly, I cannot stand Kanye. I know.
So So they actually were rumored that their relationship was on the rocks too.
I hope so.
Because of the whole like mental breakdown hospitalization thing.
Yeah.
But then a story was released today again by E! News saying that Kim is not gonna break up with him. She's gonna stay loyal.
Yeah, she
right
seems like a ride or die kind of chick.
Even though she was married for 72 days.
true. But I feel like that was for publicity.
Everyone
for money
has their
and
problems.
Yeah.
Exactly. And also, just a disclaimer: my father is not a drug addict. I just want to throw that out there. I love him. He's not a drug addict. So, but yes, I think that's great gossip. I love gossip and. We can't talk about anybody else besides the Kardashians, so I think
gotta
next time, I'm sure next time we come back, there'll be more Kardashian gossip news.
We'll get pictures from the wedding.
Exactly. Hopefully Kanye will be released, or if he's not already. But anyways, thank you guys so much for talking about gossip and drug addicts with us. We appreciate it. Hello and welcome back to Working Title / Gabbing with Girls, and we're so excited to be here. And we're talking today about one of the most magical times of the year, the holidays. Merry Christmas.
Happy Hanukkah.
Happy Kwanzaa.
It's such a good time of year. So also I just wanted to say that we're here with Nicole, Frat Boy James, and myself, Alex. So The hot toy this year, I don't know if you guys have heard, these Hatchimal things. Have you guys, are you privy?
No, what are they?
Yeah.
So, I mean, I don't exactly know. Okay. I heard a lot about them on the radio. Apparently, they almost remind me of like a Furby slash like Tamagotchi slash like the Land Before Time. Because it's like you get like this egg and it hatches and then it's like a little animal. And I think you like take care of it as though.
I did hear about that.
Yeah.
Isn't it like $280?
Exactly.
Wow.
Which like.
That's expensive.
Thank you. Like, would you buy your child, if you had a child, one?
I don't think so. That's just like way too much money.
Yeah.
For a little toy that they're not going to play with. The
exactly.
Day after Christmas.
And it's not even going to be popular in a year. But I feel like exactly. I heard that they're so hard to get. Like, people are like waiting in line for them. Like, you can't buy them online. So, like.
Wow. Well, like, I'm guessing you're not asking for a Hatchimal for Christmas.
I'm not. I must say that I'm not. What I am going to ask for, I mean, I need some new clothes because, like, I've got holes and stuff. Yeah. But I think what I want most of all is just like a big pile of money. Yeah. What are you going to ask for?
Yeah, I could go for one of those piles of money. That would be great. Or like if my mom would pay my rent for a month or something like that.
That'd be sweet too.
That'd be perfect.
You know?
Yeah.
How about you, Nicole?
You know, I love money too.
Yeah.
I don't know. I think the Amazon Echoes are really cool.
Those are cool.
Or like Alexa, that would be cool. Or, I don't know, I ask for a lot of clothes, jewelry, a lot of.
But see, if you get money, then you could just buy it on your own.
Pick out your own, yeah.
Money
but I get it.
Solves, I mean, I guess maybe that will be my New Year's resolution.
Make more money.
To make more money next
exactly.
year.
Exactly.
Yeah. No, that's so shallow.
Exactly. But I mean, like, money rules the world. I love money. Like, money buys happiness, let's be real.
Well, so what's your resolution then? To be happier or to have more money? Or both?
Us, girl.
I think one would lead to the other.
Exactly. Although yes, I did hear, though, that like money only buys happiness up to a certain dollar amount.
I've heard that too. I think it's $75,000, which seems absurdly low in my opinion.
I know, but
maybe
then
I'm
you
just
think
a diva,
about it.
Yeah.
I heard that it's like if you have enough to like buy all your necessities and then like a cushion. So like whether you have like $100,000 versus like $100 million, like the same level of happiness is equated between the two.
Interesting.
Which like I get because like what are you gonna do with $100 million?
Well, travel the world.
I mean, right,
I like
exactly.
I feel like everyone's going to have a different number.
Yeah.
I'm embarrassed because I would do a lot with $100 million. I wouldn't go to work. I would travel. I would buy everything. And I would take you guys with me.
Oh, thank you so much,
awesome.
Alex.
Where are we going to travel?
Everywhere. Italy. Oh. So.
Italy. Nice. Nice.
Yeah.
Is that another one of your resolutions? You never told me what it was.
Oh.
Is it to travel more or what?
I think it's just it is cliche and like stupid as it's gonna sound. To like be the best me that I can be. You know what I mean? Just to like, but I feel like there's so many categories that go with that. Like working more, like being healthier, like not being mean. So all those things.
Oh, I mean that's a good one, I guess.
Yeah. What are your guys' resolutions? Did you give them yet or?
I think mine is to be like less of a hater. It's really easy to like criticize and
it
like,
is.
Just to get like upset. So I just want to be less like throw less shade and just be, you know, more positive.
That's amazing. Yeah, haters back off, like the new Marina Singh show. So
exactly. That's what inspired me.
She'd be so proud to know that.
I must have missed that one. But I feel like
so what's your resolution then?
I feel like your resolution kind of like took like everybody's resolution. You like encompassed all the good resolutions like within your resolution.
Yeah, because I feel like that is in essence everybody's resolution.
I feel like, or at least that's what it should be.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, to be a better person, like give back more, which I feel like I would be philanthropic if I had $100 million, so.
But do you think that you're gonna be able to accomplish that? Because according to psychology, it's easier to reach your goals if they're more specific.
Ooh, I like that.
In general.
It is. It is a very blanket thing. I mean, like I said, I feel like there's specifics with under that umbrella.
Okay.
But just to be happy, that's specific. Yeah. Not that I'm unhappy, but just like, you know, you could always be happier.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, true.
Always.
But well, I think those are some great topics. Happy holidays. Yeah. And we want to hear what you guys want for Christmas. So leave some messages in the comment section below. Make sure you subscribe. And if you like this video, click the thumbs up button. Thank you so much. This has been Nicole, Fratboy James, and Alex. And just kill it. That's hot. Also, Kanye, I don't know why you chose to join that family. You don't like the spotlight. You don't like, you like your personal, you like your privacy. It's like, what, like, what? Why would you...
like, some people just like staying out of the spotlight, and other people just like to cause a ruckus.
Exactly.
Like,
when we're filming in the studio. Did you not see the on-air sign there? What is, she's an intern, right? What's her name?
Who even is she?
Morgan, Matilda, we forget. But do you see the cameras here? The lights, the display, the microphones, the people standing at the desk.
Oh, Alex, she brought you a coffee. That's why she's here.
I did ask for a coffee, didn't I? Thank you, I appreciate it. Is this Starbucks? So it's Starbucks. But you knew that I put on my list of things that I do or do not want. I don't want Starbucks. You know I have a very tumultuous relationship with Starbucks because I used to work there before I got this job and I hated it. I broke my ankle and four toes and I don't like that being remembered in my brain. So I don't know why you would give me this Christmas holiday themed cup when we're on the air and then to top it off, it's Starbucks. What kind of coffee is it? Did you put cream? Did you put sugar? What's in here?
Wait. You don't like Starbucks?
No, but actually I feel a little bad because it's McDonald's. Smells sweet. Did you want to smell it?
I'm okay, thanks.
I'm not gonna let you smell it. Ouch! It's hot! You burned the milk! What is wrong with you? Like, why would you even think? I'm leaving. Oh. I'm leaving. I'm leaving this right now because I can't handle it. Just leave it. Just leave it right there. Because you already screwed it up enough. And now I have to pick up that microphone because I'm leaving out of the same door that you left that ruckus with. And I'm taking my coffee. Cut that part out.
Do you play the lottery a lot? I don't know if that's...
No, oh, I don't. Okay. Like, occasionally, like, if I have the extra money, I'll, like, buy a scratch ticket, yeah. You know, whatever.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry. I think I'm just going to call. Since this is on tape, I'm just going to... I think this is...
We're doing something, though, like, over here.
Hello?
Oh, okay.
I guess we're Hello. Doing this without yeah, Alex
Too good
now.
For us Hello. Now.
How dare you say that to me? This is really important.
Who is he talking to?
I have no
This
clue.
Is really important... My dog needs that surgery.
So that money.
She's already only has three legs.
He really needs to buy a dog leg. Yeah. Yeah.
That blood needs to be cleaned up by the time I get home because I don't want to smell it. I don't like that.
What is happening?
It's like gross and just nasty and it's not my blood. Is it yours? Is that your blood?
I know.
This is foul. Everywhere?
I thought it was the dog.
You're my cleaning lady, so go clean up the blood, lady. Wear a Band-Aid next time. And walk my dog at the same time, because I don't like that. She comes home and she shits all over my floor. And it's all your fault, dog? So.
Oh my goodness.
Is everything okay?
So what's your New Year's resolution?
To stop bleeding so much.
What happened there?
Yeah, wait, what?
What on earth?
Money.
It
all stems back to money.
What's your dog's name?
Fiction.
What's your cat's name?
Nonfiction. The cat doesn't eat and the dog eats the cat food and then the dog bleeds everywhere and she doesn't walk it, she doesn't clean it up and she's the laziest house cleaner.
It sounds like you did a pretty bad job training your pets.
Thanks.
Did you say your dog had three legs at some point there?
Yeah, James, you've been at my house.
I don't remember seeing a three-legged dog.
That's what's the problem with you frat boys. It's like fried eggs up here, scrambled.
I would have remembered a three-legged dog.
She bled on your shoe. There's still a stain. That's why I'm telling you, the cleaning lady needs to get her together. Because the dog is being fed cat food, which gives it an ulcer, and then it just bleeds out all over my floor. And I don't like it, and I don't appreciate it. And if you're watching this, Esmeralda, get it together, because I'm gonna yelp your and you're never gonna get work again.
Okay. Also, you like how you said no spoilers, and I'm like, boys, you guys.
I know. Like, girl power! So. All right, I'm ready to do this. I'm so ready. Are you ready? Because I'm ready. Hello. Oh, hey, there you are. Come on in. This is it. This is our beautiful newsroom. It's a bit loud in there. Those are some of our interns over there. Some of them are on the show with me on the broadcast, and let's go take a look. These are our beautiful interns. How you guys? What you guys doing over here?
Working.
Okay. Well, this looks like YouTube to me. Are you guys getting some ideas? You know, getting really creative, getting those juices flowing.
Yeah.
Is that what you guys are doing?
Exactly.
That's fine.
So, what news package are you guys working on today? Because I know that we have a show this afternoon. I hope you guys are ready.
Yep.
Yeah. So, how's the internship going? I know you guys have been doing it for a while. What's your favorite part? Do you love me? So.
You like that.
Okay, well, great. It's been a great talk, so I'll see you guys later. Make sure you guys get back to the working, because I know we have a show later to do, so get back to it.
What is that one again?
The news package on the armadillos? You pitched it this morning.
No, the show.
Oh, it's Shark Week, so we're doing the opposite of Shark Week, every other animal but sharks. That's what we had proposed in the meeting this morning, Christina.
Remember we went to go to the armadillo museum?
Exactly. So coming back to me now. Exactly. You should. Thank you, Nicole.
You're welcome. You should just know that Fatboy James still hasn't come to work yet.
Over here is a wall of accolades, achievements, if you will. This one right here is my favorite because it's got some really good quotes on there. This right here, it's a very prized possession. This right here is our gorilla fund. We adopted a gorilla, and each year, back in 2002, so must be a story. This is Alex. Who's there? This over here is my supervisor, the one who gave me the beloved job that I have today, Diana.
What are you doing here? I fired you.
But I have to do the news story. Remember, that was before, and then you rehired me back.
No, you're fired.
So should I not do the broadcast? We're in the interview. I thought you said that you would fire me after this wedding. Well, let's just finish our tour, and then I have to go. Here's where we keep our cameras. They're out on a news story right now. For the armadillos. Now this stapler. Over here. So this was the stapler that we got the day that this station was founded. So that's why this is important. Let's go check back in with our interns. So right this way over here. Hey intern. Why don't you go ahead and explain to them what this signifies? So go ahead and listen.
You were talking about that.
So if we get a news story.
Sometimes we run late to our news packages, so we need to pretend that we are police so we can get there on time. So we just put that on top of our car.
If somebody calls on the phone, just like they did before, you signal this bell. So, right this way.
We just learned from you, in terms of punctuality.
What can I say?
Has Scrapboy James showed up yet? Have you seen Fatboy James yet?
No, I haven't, and it's really hot in here, but I haven't seen him. Let's come in here. This is the broadcast station. So if you want a fade in, you do like that. If you want a fade out, you just do it the opposite way. So that is our control room. So. And then, here is the most important part of it all. Right through these doors. Oh, hey. So right through these doors, this is the studio. So this is where we come back here and we do our news stations, we broadcast, and you know, we just tell every single person everything that they should know. So that's what happens over here. These are our fancy cameras. This one displays words. Through here, there's some technical stuff, and that's pretty much about it. I hope you enjoyed our tour. And I have to go now because I already have a warrant out for my arrest, and she's going to call the cops. So I've got to go, but it's been great. Welcome to my crib, and I'll see you later. So.
Is that really a sport, beer pong?
Is it a sport?
Is it a real sport? No.
You don't think so?
I don't think so either. What do you think? Do you think it's a sport?
Do I think beer pong is a sport? Mm-hmm. I probably wouldn't call it a sport, no.
Like ultimate frisbee?
Ultimate frisbee? I don't think that's the best comparison.
Isn't ultimate frisbee actually a sport?
Yeah, I feel like ultimate frisbee is a sport.
So if that's a sport, how come
beer pong's a game?
What's the difference between a sport and a game?
I don't know. I guess a sport takes some, like, athletic coordination? I have no idea. I just uncoiled.
What's your record for beer pong playing?
Alex, I don't know the exact number, but I don't lose a lot. And I don't really remember the last person I lost to. So, ask me what my record is. That's almost disrespectful.
I'm sorry.
Because everybody knows I don't lose. You got that? I can't get this thing to go through this thing. Boy.
Spoken like a true frat boy.
I'm just going to sit down through this. I think it'll make it easier. Best thing about being in a frat, you're not supposed to talk about being in frats. So I don't think I should tell you what my frat would be.
Why? What's the secret?
Can't talk about it.
Why?
I have no idea.